waste of fucking time.
What's up, everybody, and welcome to the second Raw pay-per-view of the year, and welcome to Unforgiven. I'm one of your commentators, Joshua Wojcik, aka Hex Phenom, and I'm joined by Tyler. Tyler, welcome to the Raw pay-per-view Unforgiven.
Can we get this poopy over with and just go straight to the next SmackDown pay-per-view?
Well, I mean, we've got some great matches first here tonight. But before we get into any of the matches, I just wanted to take a second to break character here and apologize to you guys for the lack of videos and streams and stuff recently. I actually was having a lot of technical issues, and I ended up having to get a whole new PC. So it was, you know, I was basically struggling through it using my old PC while I saved up for my new one. But I have my new PC, so thankfully, you know, things should be back on track. So expect more content here soon. But guys, thank you so much for your patience. We're back with Unforgiven. And guys, it's going to be an incredible show here tonight. In your main event, Damian Priest defends the World Heavyweight Championship against AJ Styles in a ladder match. And that is sure to be an absolute banger of a match. We've got Keith Lee taking on Samoa Joe in a steel cage match.
They reinforced the ring for that this time?
That's a great question.
I would hope so.
For the United States Championship. But Tyler, in this particular steel cage match, you cannot escape from the cage. The only way to win is through pinfall or submission inside the cage. And there's so many other crazy rivalry matches going on tonight. But before we head into your opening matchup, we need to thank 3 Days Grace for the song So Called Life. It's the official theme song of Unforgiven. You can stream it now on Spotify or Apple Music. And I didn't say what album it was off, I don't think. It's off their album Explosions. So it's an explosive song. Like I said, you can stream it now on Spotify. But guys, let's get into your opening matchup. Walter is taking on Shinsuke Nakamura, and that match starts right now. Alrighty, getting into your opening matchup. Walter taking on Shinsuke Nakamura.
Shinsuke was starting strong with those kicks.
But now Walter, the ring general, taking over.
Oh.
Just cranking the neck over and over. Oh, Shinsuke with a reversal.
You're doing some smart thinking here. Work on the kicks, go for the head, try to get him disoriented, all dizzy.
It's not a bad strategy here. And of course, we saw Nakamura go for the low blow in their match on Raw last week. And let's hope he doesn't do it again. Of course, this match, it's a normal match, so there is disqualifications. So, oof, and a big combination of strikes from Walter, though Walter trying to get some payback, maybe, for that low blow on Raw. And now the repeated big meaty fist to the head.
He's got some big meaty claws.
It's true. Shinsuke rolling out of the way of that knee.
Oh!
Ooh, the strength of Nakamura. Just planting Walter to the mat.
Fans impressed.
Ooh, and a big running knee. Not quite a Kinshasa, but looking for the pinfall nonetheless. One, no, kick out by Walter. Oh, and a big kick to the face, adding insult to injury.
Shinsuke know what he has to do to keep Walter down for a 3 count.
I mean, he tried to use a low blow, like I said, on Raw. Didn't work. The referee caught it, but speaking of the ref, running face first into the referee and Walter.
I gave him enough time.
Gonna take advantage with the tackle there. And is that enough to put Shinsuke away?
One, two.
No, kick out at two by Shinsuke Nakamura. And the big meaty claws coming back out to play, but Nakamura retaliating with a strike of his own. And now a combination and a beautiful bicycle kick. Now Nakamura heading up to the top.
Deep thinking.
Ooh, big knee right across the face of Walter.
Go for the pin again. Is this it?
No, kick out at 2.5.
Woo!
It was close. Close, but no cigar.
Shinsuke arguing it.
Walter looking to get some offense in and a big kick of his own.
Oh, that'll push the air right out of you.
It's a good point. And now, again, focusing right on the forehead of Shinsuke Nakamura. Oh, and repeated stomps to the chest, trying to get the last breath out of Nakamura. Is that enough to put him away? No.
Not yet. Now,
Shinsuke with the dragon screw, planting Walter, but Walter trying to get back to his feet, but Shinsuke says no. Walter again.
Trying to get the air out of him as well.
Oh. Walter ducks out of the way in that tackle again. Now what's Walter looking for? Oh, reversal by Shinsuke.
Shinsuke going back up to the top.
It worked last time. Let's see what happens. Calling for Walter to get up.
And no!
Oh, the strength of Walter!
Just slamming him down.
Catching him midair and slamming him right down to the ground and a big knee to the side of the head. Looking for it a second time. Oh, and third time's the charm to the side of the head.
Shinsuke even know where he's at.
Oh, and that big meaty chop. Is that enough to put Shinsuke down? No, kick out at 2.
He's the king of strong style. You got to do more than that to keep him down.
That's true. But we are talking about the Ring General. What's Shinsuke looking for?
Going for his kicks. And,
taking the air right out of Walter.
And never-ending kicks.
Oof, right across the face. Is that enough to put Walter away?
Come on, 1, 2.
No, 2.5. Almost had him.
Shinsuke's gonna have to hit that Kinshasa. Whatever it is.
Yeah, I'm not 100% sure either, to be honest with you. But, and throwing Shinsuke face first into the mat, and the big knee connects this time.
Just clobbering on him.
Walter.
Do you think?
Ooh, and a big clothesline.
Nearly decapitated him.
Oh.
Walter's calling for the end.
Calling for the end. Is this it?
A power bomb.
Big power bomb. And is that enough to put Shinsuke away? 1, 2, 3.
That's it.
And Walter picks up the big victory to start off Unforgiven.
That power bomb was unforgivable.
That's true. The Ring General. Showing why he commands this ring.
Powerbomb, compliments of Captain Insano.
It's very true.
You're too young to even know that movie.
Yep, sure am.
You uncultured swine.
Listen, Tyler. You're 100% right.
Uh-huh. That's what I thought, you nincompoop.
But, Tyler, what matters most is that our next match starts right now. All right, we've got one-on-one women's action here. Ember Moon, the Sheenom, taking on Charlotte Flair. And we've seen Ember Moon be so incredibly dominant thus far.
She's not messing around here.
And, honestly, she's been women's champion more times than I could count. Charlotte Flair. You know, but Ember Moon just taking it to Charlotte. But Charlotte now.
Her own little clothesline. Another one.
Using that ring IQ. But you see Ember Moon keeps popping right back to her feet. And Ember Moon right back on the attack with a big DDT.
I think Charlotte was underestimating Ember Moon here.
And Ember Moon with a flying senton from the middle rope. And a soccer kick right across the back of Charlotte. Oh, but Charlotte. Knee to the face and a drop kick.
Oh no.
Ember Moon moving out of the way and throwing Charlotte right back down to the mat.
Ember's been strategizing here.
Soccer kick to the back. Oh, and Ember Moon, you hear her yelling in the middle of the ring, running senton.
Yeah, I think these fans are loving it.
It sounds like they are. And a big snap suplex.
Yeah. Oh.
Dragon screw reversal there by Charlotte, though.
Going up to the top. Doesn't realize Ember's right there.
Oh, slapping her right off the top rope. Oh. Ooh. The knees driven right into the ribs of Charlotte. Flair, and now working that arm yet again. And across the back again. Ember Moon headed up to the top.
She already going for the end? No.
No, but a big frog splash.
There's a little froggy there.
Is that enough to put away Charlotte Flair here? One, two, no.
Not just yet.
Oh, Charlotte rolls out of the way.
Ember rolls. Oh.
Right into a drop kick from Charlotte Flair. And now Charlotte.
Another one.
With a combination of strikes, ending in another drop kick, like you said.
Now working on the leg.
Working the leg. Good strategy, trying to set up for the figure eight.
Wait, no, changing her mind.
Charlotte looking for the patented moonsault, but no.
Oh,
my God, and a running kick right to the face.
Ember is more than ready right now.
Oh, my God. And up to the top, and I think she's calling.
I think I see an eclipse coming.
Eclipse! And is that enough to put away Charlotte Flair? One,
so.
Two,
and
three!
Yes!
Ember Moon with the dominant victory over Charlotte Flair. And as we know, Charlotte Flair, one of the toughest competitors here on the Raw roster, and Ember Moon just made light work of her.
It's always a good time seeing Charlotte lose, though.
I mean, the fans are loving it, they agree with you.
I love it. You love it. We all love it. Everybody loves it.
But my question is, who can stop Ember Moon, if anybody?
Elvis?
Oh, maybe.
Just throwing it out there.
I mean, it's a possibility. It's a possibility. That's for sure. But Tyler, we've got your Raw Tag Team Championships on the line coming up next. The Viking Raiders trying to capture the Raw Tag Team Championships from the defending RK-Bro. Let's get into it, starting right now. All righty. Oof! Raw Tag Team titles on the line.
Not
here.
Down, though.
RK-Bro defending the titles against the Viking Raiders. And the Viking Raiders already off to a explosive start here at Unforgiven. Double team on Orton! And slam down to the ground.
The Viking experience already?
Is that enough to put Randy away?
Oh,
no.
Oh.
Orton kicks out. Going to take a little bit more to put him away. Right off the start. Not a bad strategy here by the Viking Raiders.
How did he kick out of that already?
I don't know. Oh, but Orton trying to... the strength of Randy! And now Orton back on the offensive.
Telling him to get up.
Orton not happy with the way this match started.
Orton just got shot with adrenaline here.
Oh, and again! The power of Randy Orton. Oh, going for his partner there, but ooh, what a big kick to the back.
Now, Ivar suplex.
And a big knee right to the face. Is that enough to put Orton away?
Champs.
No. Orton, quite resilient as we know, but man, even I'm surprised he's still going.
Shot right to the stomach.
Orton's got a tag in Riddle and a power slam. Shades of Orton there from Ivar. And now back in comes Eric. Orton.
Taking a beating here.
And a big knee to the face again. Orton needs to get to his corner. Can he do it? And another knee right to the face. Is that enough to put Orton away? New champs, no.
Riddle was about to break it up.
Riddle was trying to break it up.
Yeah.
Orton backed into the corner. And in comes the fresh Matt Riddle.
Yeah, Eric, whoop.
And now some big strikes of his own. Matt Riddle with a big knee to the face.
Where the hell's his scooter?
That's a good question. And you see Riddle using his MMA experience to his advantage here.
The bro knows exactly what he's doing.
Oh, but sweep of the leg. Oh, back to his feet, though.
Wait it.
Smack to the face. Two smacks and throws him down with authority.
Of course that wasn't gonna work.
And now locked in elbows to the head. And again focusing on that arm. Just wrenching it.
That was a rhyme and a reason. The reason he's going for that arm.
Maybe looking for an arm bar later on. Oh, what are we about to see? The strength of Matt Riddle with a deadlift German suplex.
I was going to say, that wasn't about to be PG.
Oh, the rope break.
Went right under there.
Just barely, but I respect the referee's call. He knows better than me, that's for sure.
Oh,
reversal there. And exchanging blows, and now a big clothesline taking Riddle down. Knee across the face of Riddle.
Didn't fall.
Is that enough to put away Riddle? No.
This ain't over.
It's not over till the fat lady sings.
Where is she?
I don't know.
Right to the back.
Reversal here by Riddle. And a tackle. A spear, if you will, not quite sure, but whatever it was
targeting
effective.
Those arms again.
Really focusing on the arms, trying to make sure that Eric can't lift him up, but Eric can still use the leg to get that reversal in, and now stomping the arm.
Focusing on his own arms. Again.
A little payback.
Chop. And
focusing on the arm again, but Riddle.
Forearm to the face. Another tackle.
Not tackle yet again.
Now. Yep.
Wrenching the arm again.
Going back and forth with these arms.
Gosh.
Taking away all the power.
Oh, looking for that German. Oh.
Nope. Riddle.
Eric was smart. He slid out of it that time. Oh, and now what are we going to see?
Oh.
Oh, and multiple chops across the chest with a big fist.
What is he, Sheamus?
Well, you know.
Riddle without his partner now.
What's Riddle gonna do?
Oh!
And just bent right over the knee. One, two, no kick out. Riddle's gotta survive until Orton gets back up on the apron.
Back up now. Whoa.
Oh, there's Orton and a running Superman punch.
Exactly what he needed.
And focusing on the arm again. And now in comes the Viper.
Eric doesn't even know.
Oh, and a drop kick right to the back.
He knows now.
And Orton, multiple blows right on the bridge of the nose. It kind of rhymed. I didn't mean to do that, but it's fine.
Sure.
I'm a poet and I didn't know it, Tyler. But Orton, the stomp right to the midsection and walking right over him.
Oh.
Having words with Ivar. Oh, and a drop kick sends him down to the outside of the ring.
Yep, right to the back.
Oh.
Stomp.
Vintage stomp. Orton.
And a stomp. And a stomp.
Oh. But Ivar.
Challenging.
Calling for him again.
What's he thinking?
Oh. What's Randy doing?
And
oh my God, a back suplex right on the apron.
Oh.
And now Orton up to the top rope. Oh, and oh my God, jumping right over. Eric hit Ivar.
Oh.
And Matt Riddle wants to get in on the action too.
And
oh my God. Bodies flying everywhere.
Now Orton.
Some insane action here.
Oh. Eric didn't even know where he was.
Absolute catastrophe on the outside of the ring here at Unforgiven. Back in the ring. Oh my gosh.
What the hell?
Ivar, oh, trying to break things up. He is not happy. Oof, and taking out Orton.
Finally.
Now getting back out of the ring, and now Ivar looking to take advantage. Or sorry, Eric looking to take advantage. Is that enough to put Orton away?
Oh!
Ooh, quick
Adrenaline
kick out.
Kicking in again. Dag.
And in comes Ivar. He wants to get his hands on Orton yet again.
He's like, Orton. He's going to get the hands.
Oof. Orton was prepared for it, though. And now just trying to drag the big man back towards his corner, having a little trouble.
That's a big boy.
That is a big boy, that's for sure. Oh, but Ivar, we're going to get some payback here. Oh, where's he going?
Oh.
And like a freight train, right across the midsection of Orton.
What's he doing here? Tossing under the rope. And a
big
slam.
Power slam again.
Oh boy. No.
Up to his feet. RKO!
Okay.
Out of nowhere, is that enough to... The rope break. And Orton's pissed. A rookie mistake. Trying to take out his anger on Eric, and they're having words. Oh, looking for another back suplex on the apron, this time to Eric.
Oh.
And back to the outside we go.
And
the strength of Orton.
Adrenaline is really kicking in.
Now Orton back in the ring.
Now.
And a second RKO.
Out of
Is
nowhere.
That enough?
And
three,
yes.
RK Bro retain the Raw Tag Team Championships.
Ivar not only ran into the ring, but he ran into an RKO.
For the second time, an RKO out of nowhere. That time perfectly placed in the middle of the ring, no rope break in sight.
Got lucky the first time with the rope, second time, not so much.
And while the Viking Raiders did take a loss, man, they put on a great showing here tonight.
And Ivar's showing he's magical by just teleporting through the ropes like that.
I mean, yeah, we don't know what kind of stuff they used to do in the old Norse days in Scandinavia. We don't know what they were doing back then. But what a great match. But your next match starts right now. Alright, Ricochet taking on Finn Balor. And of course this match came about because Finn Balor and Ricochet had a couple of matches back and forth the last couple of weeks, but
don't get too cocky.
Finn Balor getting a little too cocky off the start, and Ricochet gonna take advantage. But Ricochet put out the challenge on Twitter, said that he could beat Finn Balor here at Unforgiven. And here we are. And let's see if Ricochet can put his money where his mouth is.
Oh.
And I expect this to be a crazy, high-flying affair between these two.
Now, axe handle.
Big axe handle. And now Finn Balor back in the ring. And oh, and a flying cross body taken out. Ricochet. Ricochet.
Been getting amped up here.
Slow to get back to his feet now. Ricochet back in the ring. Finn calling for him to get up.
And what is this?
Go! Oh,
no!
Ricochet, though. Getting out of the way, and a big kick right to the jaw. And now Ricochet up to the top rope. And a big shooting star!
Going sideways, too!
Is that enough to put Finn Balor away? No, kick out at two.
Can't keep the first ever Universal Champion down like that.
Whoa! Oh. And Ricochet miscalculated.
Yeah.
Ooh! And a sleeper slam. Putting Ricochet on his back.
Yep. Right into the turnbuckle.
In the corner. Big combination of strikes. And now Balor up to the top.
What's he thinking?
And a big splash from Balor.
Big splash.
Is that enough to put Ricochet away? No, kick out at two.
Whoa. Now Finn grabbing the arm. Oh, just kick right to the head.
Just adding insult to injury to Ricochet right now.
Ooh.
A brainbuster of sorts there, I believe. And now Finn! Like the double axe handle there.
Oh! Shining Wizard!
Beautiful Shining Wizard right across the bridge of the nose. But Ricochet retaliating. And
clothesline!
Sending him over the top. And you see
his eyes. What's that look in his eyes?
Oh, he's thinking about it and he's going for it. Suicide dive! Sending Finn Balor head first into the announce table. Now, these guys fighting right in front of us. And a standing shooting star on the outside of the ring. And now Ricochet getting pumped up.
Oh.
And what's Ricochet? Landing on his feet, though. But a knee to the face sends him down again.
Oh, kick right to the gut.
Count of four. Carrying him in the power bomb position.
No.
Right across the apron and sent him into the apron a second time. And Ricochet's back and Finn soaring over the top rope.
He's going to restart the count.
Now Finn heading up to the top.
Calling for him.
Oh, and a big missile drop kick.
Been hurting himself there.
Hurting himself a little bit on that one. Is that going to give Ricochet too much time to kick out? Yes, it is.
Finn getting mad.
Finn getting mad, saying the referee was counting slow.
Now Ricochet. Oh!
Ricochet.
Spinning kick.
Going to get some offense here.
Right to the back of the head.
And again, focusing on that arm. Middle rope. Nope.
No. Finn getting out of the way.
Reversal again by Ricochet, though.
No.
Reversal by Balor.
German.
Into a big German suplex.
What's Finn thinking here?
Oh, Finn might be calling for 1916.
I think that's what he's doing.
And there it is.
Going for that pinfall.
And is that enough to put away Ricochet?
One.
Here at Unforgiven. Two. Oh, at the last possible second,
it
Ricochet
was right there.
Kicks out.
It was right there.
And Finn heading up to the top.
Going
looking
for coup de grace.
Coup de grace.
Oh!
Ricochet gets out of the way.
Oh! He just did it. Whoa! Oh. He kicked him and he backflipped.
And what an incredible display here by Ricochet.
On the shoulders.
And oof.
I wouldn't want to take that.
Now what's he calling for from Finn Balor? Oh, what a jumping Hurricane Rana.
What is this? The people's elbow?
Oh, looking for the people's moonsault. And is that enough to put away Finn Balor?
One, two.
No.
No, 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 no. The people's moonsault.
An incredible display here by Ricochet. Calling for Balor to get up. And I don't even know what the hell that was, but it was incredible. But Finn Balor, Finn Balor getting the better of that exchange.
Oh, kick and
Pele kick. Ricochet though.
No.
Oh, but Finn Balor, the axe big handle. Double axe handle.
Ooh. Now Finn going for a roll up.
Finn going for a roll up.
One, two, and what? Oh!
Ricochet reverses it.
One,
two, three.
Got it!
Ricochet picking up the victory here over Finn Balor with a roll up. But man, what a crazy fun match that was to watch. What a great, spectacular show of high flying ability both of these men put on for the crowd here in Baltimore, Maryland. What a match.
Ricochet threw everything and all he needed was a little roll up.
An impressive, impressive victory. And Ricochet able to deliver on what he promised, that he would beat Finn Balor here at Unforgiven.
Would you say that was luck?
I don't know. It's possible.
Could have been.
We'll have to wait and see what happens going forward. But, Tyler, we're going to have to get the ring reinforced for the next one because it is Keith Lee versus Samoa Joe in a steel cage match. And the only way to win is a pinfall or submission inside the cage. There is no escapes. There is no getting out of the cage. And it is for the United States Championship. And that match starts right now. All right, the ring has been reinforced, and it's gonna need it with these two big, beefy boys.
Names and big boys.
Keith Lee looks to capture the United States Championship yet again here against Samoa Joe. And of course, like I said, steel cage. The only way to win, a pinfall or submission inside the cage.
Right to the back.
There is no escaping the cage in this particular match. And Keith Lee, the incredible high-flying maneuvers this man could pull off at his size never ceases to amaze. You saw the Hurricane Rana there, now taking the fight to Samoa Joe with the fists.
These men never fail.
Neither of them ever fail to amaze myself and the rest of the fans. Samoa Joe wearing yellow tonight, maybe signifying that he believes he'll walk out with the title.
Not so much yellow, but I guess you could say golden.
That's a good point. It's a good point. But oof. And Samoa Joe showing off his athleticism here tonight. That jumping high kick. Sending Keith Lee flying into the cage.
Psyching him out there.
And a big uppercut, sending him right into the cage again.
Now,
into the corner. And, reversal by Keith Lee.
In the leg.
And if you guys remember, the last time these two met inside the ring literally collapsed at Judgment Day, and the match was ruled a no contest.
That was the best birthday ever!
I'm glad you enjoyed your party, Tyler.
After you embarrassed me like that.
Yeah, I just wanted you to have a good birthday. But, and Samoa Joe psyching out Keith Lee.
And notice neither of these men have gone for a pin or submission. They just want to hurt each other.
That's all they're worried about is hurting the other. And Samoa Joe doing a pretty good job at hurting Keith Lee right now. And again, ugh, into the cage.
Joe just taking his time.
Just walking slowly and menacingly. Keith Lee, though, using the headbutt, trying to get his wits about him. And now the power of Lee! Ooh! And psyching Joe out that time. A little payback.
Joe was about to just counter there.
Oh my god, tossing Samoa Joe halfway across the ring. Now trying to take out the leg of Joe. Oh, and stepping right across him. Oh, but Joe's not happy about that. Whoa.
Both of these men so dangerous. You don't know who can, wait, no.
Oh no.
This ring better be reinforced. The ring better be reinforced.
Oh.
Woo, okay, all right, we're lucky.
And thankfully, the ring didn't collapse that time, but a big suplex toss-like thing from the top turnbuckle sends Keith Lee.
Oh,
Joe
didn't see
Keith Lee get up.
Big boy's up.
Oh, dropping Joe right across his knee and stepping over Joe yet again. And a big kick to the face and again.
Just trying to squeeze all that air out of him.
Well, you know what they say, you can't kick out if you can't breathe. So, I mean, makes sense. Looking for a power bomb. Joe rolls through. Looking for a roll up.
What? Dude.
No, not enough to put Keith Lee away. Oof. Ooh. Kick to the face, but blocked by Lee. And that running hurricanrana again. Again, Tyler.
Now, Joe, whoa.
Oh. Joe right back on the offensive.
Joe thinking. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Combination of strikes sends Keith Lee down to the ground. Joe saying it's over.
Oh, is he going for the coquina?
Calling for the coquina clutch.
Now, here we go.
And he locks it in. The legs wrapped around him.
Got it.
And Keith Lee's fighting, flailing.
Just squeezing. He's squeezing him. Now.
The power of Keith Lee.
Right to the face.
And a headbutt right to the face.
Now just picking him up with a
big snap suplex.
You see how fast that was.
And now Keith Lee.
Is he calling for the end? Is Joe about to bask in the glory?
And a big spirit bomb. And is
There's
that
no
enough?
No rope break.
No rope break.
He did it!
And Keith Lee is your new United States champion.
Getting out of the coquina clutch with ease.
And able to get Joe up for the spirit bomb. And what a well-deserved championship win here tonight at Unforgiven. And Tyler, all of us here are now basking in the glory of your new United States champion, Keith Lee.
That's not just a big boy. That's a big champion. Very happy to see they learn how to reinforce the ring this time around. I got a little scared there, not gonna lie.
I was also worried. I was also quite worried. But thankfully, this match came to... Sorry, everyone.
Nincompoop.
Thankfully, this match came to a conclusive end. And Keith Lee is your United States champion. But speaking of championships, Tyler, the Raw Women's Championship is on the line next. Raquel Gonzalez defends against Sasha Banks. And that match starts right now. All right. Raw Women's Championship action. Here at Unforgiven.
Introducing the challenger.
Doing the title presentation now, and you see your challenger there, Sasha Banks, the boss.
She's fired.
What?
Because she's a lame boss.
But, in case you guys missed SmackDown. In case you guys missed Raw last week, this past week, Bayley attacking Sasha Banks after her rematch for the Raw Women's Championship. So they seem to be no longer friends. Raquel Gonzalez, though, being the nice woman that she is, scary but nice, she helped out Sasha Banks and decided to give her a shot at the title here tonight. And of course, remember, Raquel Gonzalez been on a tear recently.
Both main roster and NXT.
Yes, very true. She is your current NXT Women's and Raw Women's Champion. Will that change here tonight? Sasha Banks, though, just absolutely getting demolished right now.
Oof.
And you see those strikes hitting hard from Raquel Gonzalez.
Big Mommy Cool is not one to mess with.
But Sasha taking her off of her feet. Sasha trying to get some offense in now.
Now, snap suplex. Oof.
I feel like it's going to be tough to lock in the bank statement on an opponent this much larger than you, but we'll see. We'll see what Sasha has up her sleeve. Oh. Looking for three amigos.
Disrespecting my boy Eddie Guerrero like that.
And three.
Disrespecting my boy. But Raquel just getting right up.
Getting right back to her feet like it's nothing. And just right across the chest of Sasha Banks. Trying to take out the arm so Sasha can't lock in the bank statement. Not a bad strategy.
Trying to take everything out of her.
It's also true. And Sasha, trying to get back to her feet, but I don't think there's any point, really.
A jawbreaker. Yeah.
And Sasha using both of her knees to take Raquel down.
Pinfall.
Oh my god, not even a one count. And Raquel. Oh! Sasha,
just
though.
Getting right back up!
I'm trying to take Big Mommy Cool out by the knee, but.
Ain't happening.
No. Snapmare.
Another
off
one.
The rope. Oh, big boot, but Sasha got out of the way of that one.
Nope.
Sasha looking to end it here.
Hold up.
Trying everything she can. And a one count.
Oof.
Dropkick right to the ribs.
Trying to keep her down.
But Raquel won't stay down. Kick to the back.
Going up to the top. Right back up.
Raquel up to her feet yet again. And the strength of Big Mommy Cool.
What is
winding
she,
up.
She-Hulk?
Basically. I mean, I don't think she's a lawyer, but.
She could be.
It's true. I mean, she's doing double duty on NXT and the main roster, so who knows what else she's doing.
Oh.
Sasha.
Another clothesline. Getting right back up.
Big Mommy Cool right back to her feet. And now a diving Meteora. Is that enough?
Cover before she gets up.
To put her away. One, two. Kick out at two this time.
Oh. Damn ref getting out of the way.
Raquel rolling out of the way. And a big spine buster.
Ooh.
Is that enough to put Sasha down? No. Sasha surprisingly still in this match. Oh no, what are we going to see? Here in a big Samoan drop.
He's not even Samoan.
Oof. Wrenching the arm though is Sasha Banks.
Now, what's he going for here?
Oof.
That's got to be it. One. Two.
Kick out at two.
Well, she's finally staying down.
What does Sasha got to do to keep Big Mommy Cool down? And frog splash. She lands right on her face. And now attacking
the
lower
back. Head.
And all Big Mommy Cool up to the middle rope. Sasha, I wouldn't get up if I were you. Punch to the gut.
Sasha wants it.
Looking for potentially bank statement. Elbow from Raquel.
Right over the top.
Sending her right over the top.
I think Sasha was going for bank statement. Now just tossing her back in.
Tossing her back in. And repeated blows to the head yet again.
Oh, she's calling for it.
Calling for the end. Big
one-handed
mommy.
One-handed powerbomb.
Cool with the one-handed powerbomb. Oh. And is that enough to put Sasha away? I'm
absolutely
sure it is. Three. Raquel Gonzalez retains the I was about to say SmackDown. The Raw Women's Championship.
Even you want to get the SmackDown.
Listen, I'm just excited, Tyler, okay? I'm just excited.
I get excited every time I see Big Mommy Cool 2. You know you're in for a dominant showing. You know she's going to be more impressive. Nothing keeps her down. She stays down for all of 2 seconds. No one can stop her.
No one can stop her. And what an incredible victory. A dominant victory, as always, for Big Mommy Cool. Raquel Gonzalez retains, and she just keeps crossing people off of her list. I have no idea who's going to be able to stop Raquel. But, Tyler, it's main event time.
It's main event time.
Damian Priest looks to retain the World Heavyweight Championship in a ladder match against the phenomenal AJ Styles. And that match starts right now. All right, World Heavyweight Championship time. And as you can see, the title is suspended above the ring, getting set for our ladder match here. AJ Styles, Damian Priest, who will walk out World Heavyweight Champion.
Oh, and AJ quick to the draw.
AJ exploding out of the corner.
He's been studying.
He's been studying. He's been hunting. He's been waiting. And now he finally has his chance. You see Styles.
He wants his title back.
He's draped in gold. Hoping to get back with the big gold here tonight. And taking out Damian Priest.
And
Styles goes soaring over the top.
Styles was on fire there.
He was, and now Damian Priest looking to extinguish the flame. And now, oof, smart strategy, work the leg, make sure Styles can't climb the ladder. And you see Styles favoring that knee already.
Oh.
But, oh, it's not going to stop him from exploding.
Styles working the leg himself.
Good strategy, both men trying to work each other's legs.
Oh.
Who knows if either of these men will be able to climb a ladder. But Styles.
Stomping on the legs.
He's smaller than Priest, but that means he's quicker than Priest. And we're seeing that here to his advantage.
Now. Ooh, was that a low blow?
Oh. Of course, no disqualifications in this matchup, so even if it was, it doesn't mean anything.
Styles getting the ladder.
Styles getting the ladder. Tossing it in the ring. Now both men sliding in. Maybe Styles wasn't paying attention.
And no.
Ooh. Right on the knee. And just wrenching the back of Styles.
Thought he was going to drop him right on the ladder.
I thought he was too. And.
What is the white noise kind of. Whoa.
White noise.
Back of the head going right on the knee. Now, whoa.
Oh.
Styles dodging that.
Styles dodging out of the way.
And,
oof.
Ears will be ringing there.
And what are we going to see? Just tossing Styles.
Now, kick right to the face.
Oof. And that flying lariat yet again, or flying elbow, whatever you want to call it.
Now Styles. Dustin Priest out.
Styles in the ring all alone.
Setting up the ladder. He's going.
Oh. Styles quick to the top of the ladder. But here comes Priest in pursuit.
Oh. Nope.
Men exchanging blows on top of the ladder.
Oh.
Oh. Priest choking AJ.
No.
But Styles with the reversal.
Oh, just knocking him down.
And now, oh.
No.
Don't do it, don't do it. Elbowed from the top of the ladder.
Ladder falling down.
Now showing off a bit. Oh, but Styles, right back to it.
Styles is hurting, though.
And now the combination of strikes.
Oh, and he fell around the ladder.
And Damian's head bouncing right off of that ladder. Hopefully not concussed. Back to his feet.
Styles getting amped up.
Into the corner goes Priest.
Is he thinking? No. Oh.
Priest throws him off. Kick to the head.
Oh. And the back now, of his arm just hitting the ladder, too.
Oof. But Styles yet again.
Taking advantage of those kicks.
Styles angry he doesn't have the title anymore. As you can tell, working that knee yet again.
He's got the ladder again.
The Priest trying to get back to his feet. And face first into the side of the ladder. And Styles quick back up to the top yet again.
He's got his hands on it. Oh.
Priest realizes.
Styles doesn't want to let go.
Oh, Priest is going to force him to let go.
Oh.
Catching him in an electric chair. The strength of Priest.
Priest can't reach him. There's no way he could reach him.
Waiting for him to get up, though. And Styles
just shoving him down.
And now Styles going to take advantage with the big brain buster. As we already know, we were worried that Priest was concussed before, let alone now.
Yep. Oh, Styles.
Oh, and again.
Smart thinking.
Working the leg again.
Smart thinking here.
And that's the leg he's been working in. You see Damian tapping, but it doesn't matter. This is a ladder match. Styles letting go. You see him favoring that leg. Will Priest be able to climb the ladder on one leg?
He can tap all he wants. It doesn't matter.
Now trying to get back to his feet. But taking a leg right to the head.
Now.
The strength.
Catching him with
of
ease.
Priest.
Body slam. Now.
What are we seeing here?
Got his arms lifted. Oh!
And stretching the back out. Oh! Focusing on Styles' legs now.
Smart.
Both knees driven right into the mat.
You take out the legs, your chances go higher. And just tossing them.
The strength of Priest. Oof, and again, Styles focusing on that leg. Styles calling for something here, but Priest!
Oh my, what was that?
Even on one leg, having the strength to do that. Oh, but Styles.
Oh, kipping up.
Run into a Hurricane Rana.
Now, could he?
Phenomenal forearm.
That was phenomenal.
And I can't tell from this camera angle, but I think Priest might be busted open. And he's down. He's down for the
Styles.
Count, I think.
Oh,
no.
Getting up.
The resiliency of Priest.
He's not messing around here.
And he's able to climb the ladder.
Oh!
Quick before. Oh! Not sure what Damian Priest's strategy was there.
Styles.
Priest on wobbly legs.
Oh!
No!
Oh,
what are we gonna see?
Oh!
Oh, God. Oh, God. Superplex to the outside! Both men landing on the set-up ladder on the outside, and how the hell did Priest just get up?
I'm hurting.
Oh my God.
Broken.
And imagine how Styles feels right now.
Oh my God, I need a cigarette.
And Priest.
I don't even smoke and I need
a
cigarette.
In the ring, able to grab the title.
Oh my God.
Well, we got to get doctors out here to check on Styles. Holy hell.
That broke my back watching. I don't smoke and I need a cigarette.
And like I said, Priest, I was right. He did get busted open on that phenomenal forearm. Blood, sweat, and tears into this championship defense here tonight from Priest. But Priest, sitting at the top of the ladder of the Raw locker room, both literally and figuratively. And we're going to get doctors out here to check on Styles and also check on Priest, make sure he's not concussed from earlier in the match. But a huge congratulations to Damian Priest. And we are going to hope that Styles and both Styles and Priest are okay
here. I think Priest is okay.
But what a ladder match to end things off here at Unforgiven. And before we go, one last time, we need to thank 3 Days Grace for the song So Called Life. It's off their album Explosions. You can get it on Spotify, stream it on there, or on Apple Music, and you can get it wherever CDs are sold.
My back exploded watching that. Now kill a man.
Very true. Like I said, hopefully Styles is okay. But thank you guys so much for tuning in to Unforgiven. And we will see you next time for Monday Night Raw. Until next time, guys, have a phenomenal night.